Should you get a soundbar or build a traditional sound system? What are the pros and cons to either setup? We're not talking about those custom home theaters in a rich person's basement, but more along the average consumer's spending abilities in a living room. To help us understand that is Senior Manager of Professional Audio at DTS, Brian Slack. Sound quality is something in movie watching that is grossly overlooked by many. Movie novices often get engrossed by beautiful colors and screen sizes while often overlooking sound quality. In an effort to bridge the gap between the level of theater-style sound and TV speakers, the electronics industry introduced sound bars several years ago. Since then, the technology behind sound bars has improved, but how well do they stack up against a traditional in-home surround sound system? There are pros and cons to having one or the other.
Speaker systems, you have individual sound sources. So you might have a 5.1 setup, or you might have a 7.1 setup, or even 7.14 if you have Atmos or DTS:X. So each of those speakers is a point in space that is being driven by their own sound source. Where soundbars differ is that you have a virtualized sound system. So you might just have a single soundbar in the front of the room, and there are a number of different technologies that allow you to believe that there are speakers beside you or above you or behind you, but in fact, the whole sound source is coming from in front of you. So the downside of a sound bar is that it's not going to be perfect from any seating position. They sort of want you to be dead in the middle. The other downside is they're small. So a lot of times you can't get them very loud, nor do they have a lot of good bass response. So most of them come with extra subwoofers, or at least larger ones do.
As Brian already said, soundbar kits come in all shapes and sizes. You can get them pretty small, or you can get them fairly large. Soundbars are generally a cheaper alternative, are less complicated to set up because of the fewer pieces and wires involved, and do not take up much room. All worth keeping in mind if you have kids running around who like to grab things or are limited by the size of your living room. On the flip side, if you get a soundbar, you'll be missing out on discrete directional sound from your movies and TV shows. While technology is always improving, there's just no way to get actual sound from a direction without placing a physical speaker from where you want to hear sound from. With physical speakers to place into your room, you have greater freedom with which to calibrate and adjust your unique acoustic needs versus just a soundbar.
They're trying to perfect and make the system better so that you don't have to be in a perfect position. You know, typically the nice thing about a laptop or an iPad or a phone is you're right in front of it, staring straight at it. You're typically right in the middle of it. So for a single viewer, well, it tends to work pretty well. You know, soundbars have a little bit of a disadvantage in that way, in that you never know where the listener is going to be. You know, sure, they're obviously going to be looking at the TV, but you don't know if they're 5 feet away or 6 feet away or 10 feet away. You don't know if they're sitting off to the left. You don't know if they're one or two or three or four people listening to it. So you kind of have to have a sound field that is generally good from any position. You know, whereas when you're looking at a laptop or an iPad, well, you don't really have to worry about that. You know, they're not going to be 10 feet away from their laptop. You know they're going to be right in front of it. You know they're going to be dead in the center for the most part. So they're huge advantages to the way virtualized sound works on even like if you look at what Apple's doing with their new iMacs and doing with their iPhones and the iPads, you know, they have an enclosed ecosystem. They know how the operating system is going to work. They know that for the most part, things are coming out of iTunes. They know what their hardware looks like. So they can do a very, very good job with virtualizing that sort of thing. But that's on a pretty limited set of hardware. Basically, you have to be watching on your laptop where, you know, a lot of people don't want to consume the media that way. You know, they want to consume it on a big 65-inch TV, you know, or a 70-inch TV.
While a traditional surround sound system will cost you more money and time, I can tell you from experience, it's completely worth it. There are differing levels of traditional surround sound options with which to set up your room with. You can get out-of-the-box kits from nearly every speaker brand out there, or you can buy individual pieces and put it together as your budget sees fit. Once you start getting into setting up your system, you can start utilizing calibration tools to further optimize your sound system to account for some things like room size and pressure, frequency crossover, and speaker distance. All items that a large majority of soundbars don't allow you to account for. And don't forget, if you got a good enough receiver, you can start expanding the system to take full advantage of all the audio sound designers put into the projects. Tell me in the comments below if you have a soundbar or a traditional surround sound system and why you chose it over the other. This is Movie University, education in cinema.